that you would hope to achieve if you were elected?
Two approaches to it. First of all, the product approach is what do we need to focus on first? I think the High Plains Community Center, which is our most used town building, we need to finish the remodeling of that to rebuild it as best we can so that it's highly functional and beautiful. When you walk into the place, it's just not acceptable for a town of our quality to have such a low quality community center, in my opinion. We need to fix that. And we need to have fixed it for quite a while. So that's a product that I'd like to see improved on immediately. We've gone a long ways with our roads, and particularly the main travel roads, but there's an awful lot of work that has been deferred on those, the lesser traveled roads. And I think all of you who drive around here, visiting people, you know some of those roads. We need to get to those. We need to actually maintain them before they begin to show signs that they're falling apart. That's what I want to see in terms of product as well. In terms of process, though, I want to see the town more engaged in planning for these things so that we have it budgeted out over the future. Our current town budget has $100,000 for all bridges and roads. That's not enough. That's not how it has been in the past, and I think we need to be more realistic about what it's going to take on an annual basis to maintain our roads so that we're not having to rebuild some of them after they fall apart.
Thank you. Mr. Scioli.
The infrastructure of Orange is extremely important. Without it, you go nowhere. The town has a continuously rolling improvement plan. We have a five-year plan that the town engineers have developed over time with different projects to be programmed and built into the overall process of the town. The Board of Education, I believe, has a plan of continuous repair projects and updating and upgrading as well. I think there's been at least 5 years. I'm not 100%, but I believe so. The Highway Department has a continual list of work that are being done, and we receive state money called Town Aid Road money that we use for that. We receive other aid and assistance money from a couple other programs for that. We have LOCIP money, the local capital improvement money, which we use for that. The money that's in the general budget is for the general operation on a yearly process. But the town continually is looking to improve and repair your roadways. The community center was part of a bond project, the South Wing. Unfortunately, some staff that's no longer with us had compiled some figures under advisement from their planners to report to the bond oversight committee, and seemed okay, but then as the process moved on, it didn't quite pan out to what was needed. So people have been changed in positions that were overseeing that, professionals, that is, not the volunteer committee. And we're moving forward with that. We will need some more money to redo that South Wing. There's over $1 million in the kitty right now for it, but it's going to take another $1 million on top of that to redo it. My time is up.
Thank you. Mr. Lentz, any rebuttal?
Just briefly, I mean, what I heard, that's what I call Jim speak. What I heard really was kind of an apology for not doing it right the first time. We started the process of planning. It wasn't accurate. We ended up underestimating it. We couldn't finish it. We need to plan better on that kind of a project. So I would certainly want to see the selectmen and our professional staff involved in the planning process and not leaving it entirely on the volunteer boards so that when these plans are made, they're really solid plans that we can depend upon a timeline. As it happens in industry, you can depend upon a timeline. When a factory is going to be built in 5 years, things are done in year one and two and so forth. Which brings me to the last point. And there's a bridge in town that 2 years ago, the state said, we have to repair this in poor condition. You know what we've done in 2 years? Zip. Now we've got spend $2 to $4 million, and it's not in this budget. So that's the kind of failure of a plan that I'm concerned about.
Mr. Zioli, any rebuttal?
A little clarification, it's not Jim speak. It's Jim, anybody who knows Jim, it's the truth of what is out there. For the sake of people's names and embarrassment, I won't go any further, but I suggest anybody in this room or watching this TV, including Ken, speak to Mitch off camera since he is on the Bond Oversight Committee. He will explain to you what happened with engineering and architecture. It was not the volunteers that were short on the dollar numbers there. It was the professionals on that. The bridge that Ken's talking about on Derby Milford Road is in planning stage, and the town engineer went to the Bond Oversight Committee just a few weeks ago for a specialist engineering firm to oversee that project. It's approximately a $2 million project with approximately 46% state reimbursement on it. So there is planning being done for that as well. You have to plan before you move. Some of these things require specialists in order to do it. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. That concludes the Q&A portion of our debate. Now we'll ask each candidate to take 2 minutes and offer a closing statement.